Survivors of the crash, still bearing the scars, spent much of the day reliving the Cannon Street disaster. 24-year-old Helen Croxford was trapped for 2 hours after her foot smashed through the wall of a carriage. Others, like Patricia Webb, are suffering psychological effects.
So I was trapped by the leg, well, just by the right leg. I was able to get my left leg free and I was there for 2 hours.
What sort of effect has this had on you?
It's made travelling very difficult. We're very nervous about travelling in crowded trains now, and that's been difficult recently with the snow and the bomb scares. Also won't use the tube and I won't travel into terminuses.
So it's had quite a major psychological effect?
It has, yes.
The inquiry heard a total of 542 people were injured, double previously reported figures. The emergency services were praised, but ambulance officials were closely questioned about the use of buses to take 100 people to hospital. Passengers told the inquiry the train slowed down as it approached the station, but coasted along at up to 10 or 12 miles an hour before it hit the buffers. Earlier, British Rail told the inquiry that tests on the train found no mechanical failure and the brakes were in perfect working order. Tomorrow, the driver of the train is expected to tell the inquiry his version of events. This is Mike Pearce of the Cannon Street Inquiry for Thames News.